We've joined the company in the past month, although we invite everyone to come on, especially those who were involved in introducing those newcomers to the company. I apologize for the lighting in this condo where I'm at. It appears to make me look like I only have one eye. I assure you, I do have two eyes, but bear with me tonight. We're going to introduce you to the company. You know, we don't always know what someone is told when they first join, that gets them interested in the company. Usually it has to do with the products. And so we will be talking about the products tonight. We'll be talking about what we refer to as epigenetic products. I see, Maria Antonetta, that you have a lot of initials after your name. And so I don't know what area of science or research that you have been involved with. I don't know if it crosses over into anything that we'll be discussing tonight, but I can assure everyone on the call, whether you have a PhD after your name or not, that, that the products have a very rigorous, strong scientific foundation. I usually keep the initials that are after my name quiet, because when I tell people that I'm a recovering lawyer, sometimes all of them start leaving the call at one time, just on principle. But I can tell you that the products do help me recover from my previous experience as an international corporate lawyer. And we'll talk more about those things as well. So what I'd like to do, and this will be a bit of a review for some of you that have seen this before, but I'm going to utilize a PowerPoint that I've used before. And so I'm going to share my screen. I think, Angie, I'm able to do that, correct?
That's correct.
Let's see if I can figure this out. Hey, I'm getting better at this. What do you say? Well, just as I say that, I passed by about three slides, so I guess I'm not that great. But for those of you that are new to the company and have not seen this before, it's important, I think, when you join with a company, when you invest any amount of money and certainly any amount of time, and more importantly, when you invest your reputation in order to talk to other people about it, it's really usually important to know a little bit about the people who founded the company, what their experience is. Do they have a track record of success or not? Do they seem to know what they're talking about? Or do they just seem like good people that are trying to do something and hope that they're successful? Well, we do think that we are good people and we hope to be successful. But the good news is that we do have a strong track record of success, both individually as well as collectively. As I mentioned, I'm a lawyer by training. My background was with large international law firms. I speak Japanese, and most of my work was with large companies in the past. But back in the mid-90s, I left that behind and joined a company as their general counsel, as their in-house lawyer, that was a small supplement company, just as the industry of dietary supplements was really getting going due to some new legislation that had been passed in the United States. That company was based in Colorado, and after a couple of years, I became the president of that company, and we expanded revenues quite a bit by going into new and additional sales channels, not just mom and pop health food stores, but into what was referred to as the food, drug, and mass arena. So not just stores like GNC, but also grocery stores, drug stores, and the big box mass market guys. I then went from there to a company called Metabolife, which was a diet company, and we became the largest diet company in the world, and had a very good run there, and was also at companies like LifeVantage, which is where I met Ryan Thompson, Angie Hawthorne, and many of the team that are with us today at Actives, and I met some of you on this call. And that was a little company that at the time that I joined was a public company that had had a brief flurry of success in about 2006 on the basis of a very positive video that was, or program, I should say, about its primary product, a product called Protandim, that had been introduced and developed by a famous scientist, probably the world's foremost authority on free radical biology, a scientist by the name of Dr. Joe McCord, who had spent all of his research, all of his years of research, I should say, in the area of free radicals and oxidative stress, which is the cumulative damage caused by free radicals, and what effect that had upon health. And more importantly, how can we, if at all, make a difference in that oxidative stress? Well, ABC Primetime did a very positive piece on that. Company caused the revenues to go from virtually zero to, over the next 45 days, they did about $5 million worth of revenue. Their share price went from about $1.20 up to $21. And they thought that they were off to the races. Well, by virtue of a lot of inexperience and not having nearly the type of team that I have working with me today, they when I joined them in 2008, they weren't doing $5 million a month. They weren't doing $5 million a year. They were doing about $3 million a year, losing $1 million, and were very close to going out of business. And I'm sure they hired me thinking that I was going to take them into mass market and repeat what I'd done with other companies and take them into Costco's and Walmart's and Target and Walgreens and things like that. But I told the board, which was filled with scientists and finance people, I said, you know what? This product is not appropriate for retail. It's too complicated. The story about oxidative stress of basically the body and the cells of the body rusting and being damaged by free radicals and how that leads to over 200 diseases. It's a great story. It's a compelling story, but you can't expect a GNC clerk, let alone a Walmart clerk, to tell that to customers that come in the door. It's just not going to happen. And it's too big of a story, too complicated to put on a label. And you don't have the expertise to do infomercials and e-commerce. So I suggest that you go into network marketing. Now, all of them, had the same response that maybe some of you have had in the past, as well as people that know that you've joined a company like ours. They said, oh, no, we're never gonna go into network marketing. Everybody knows that's, you know, if we do that, those guys are all just pyramid schemes, we'll all go to jail. And everybody knows that those companies sell nothing but snake oil products and make all these crazy claims and everything. We're never gonna do that. And I said, whoa, time out. I said, first of all, if you obey the law, you're not a pyramid scheme. And if you do things in the correct fashion, if you tell the truth, you're not going to have to worry about bad, you know, illegal or outrageous claims. And we know that we don't have snake oil because our products have human clinicals. We have patents. We have all types of intellectual property. So let's do this. So they said, well, I guess it's okay. Nothing else that we've done has ever worked. So go ahead. Well, the whole idea of going into network marketing seemed like a good one on the surface, because after all, the largest dietary supplement companies in the world are all network marketing companies. Whether they be Amway. Now, a lot of people tell jokes about Amway, and sometimes there's a lot of negative things said about Amway. However, Amway is laughing all the way to the bank, as they do about $1 billion in revenue a month. And they're also by far the world's largest purveyor of multivitamins. And so they don't really care what a lot of people think because they keep going. But what is the case is that I didn't know anything about network marketing. I was a retail guy and a lawyer by background. So I needed some people. I needed to surround myself with people who had a track record. And so in that particular case, I was just like you. I was very interested in the network marketing channel. I knew that it could be a very effective channel, and I believed in the products, but I didn't really know too much about how to be successful in network marketing. So in that particular case, I did what I encourage all of you to do. I found out and I surrounded myself with people who had a lot more experience and had success in this space. The one thing I didn't do was surround myself with people who said, oh, network marketing never works. But don't you know that? I didn't surround myself with people who had no experience in network marketing. I found the best. And those people were in the form of Ryan Thompson, who had grown up in the industry, so to speak, through great companies like Nu Skin and Tahitian Noni, and others, and Angie Hawthorne, who had also been at New Waves and Noni and other companies. And they were just coming off a very successful experience in which they'd grown a company in 18 months from zero to about almost $50 million a year in revenue. And I was very fortunate, because you might say, well, why did they leave such a fantastic company? Well, because the owner of that company actually had some real flaws and some real character flaws. And so they had the integrity to walk away from something that they just knew was based upon a poor integrity. And so fortunately for me, they walked right into our arms, so to speak, and we had a tremendous experience together in creating a company that went from $3 million a year in revenue and losing $1 million to over $215 million a year and listed on NASDAQ and had a great, great experience. So about 4 years ago, almost exactly 4 years ago, we decided to get the gang together. We'd all left that company, LifeVantage, including the chief scientist, Dr. McCord, whom I'd mentioned earlier. And he had created a company, a research company called Pathways Biosciences. And because research was really his life and because of staying, you know, his desire to stay on the cutting edge of research in regard to oxidative stress, he wanted to continue pushing the ball forward. And indeed he did. Now, by that time, in the early days of LifeVantage, we didn't know this, but by the time I left and subsequently we knew that the reason that this product Protandem was working so well was because it was doing something called, it was activating a transcription factor, which is a protein, a specialized protein that the body uses, in this case, one called NRF2. And think of it as kind of a package of instructions to other genes as to what to do under certain circumstances. You know, we often think that, well, our genes are our genes and there's nothing that we can do about it. That's just not true. We really can't change which genes we have and which genes we don't have. That is pretty much set when we're born. But what we can do is we not only can, but we do affect whether those genes turn on or turn off, what's called expressing. And we do that by the things that we eat, the air that we breathe, our lifestyle, whether we exercise or not, and countless other things. Even scientists now think, going to the very thoughts that we think can influence the genetic behavior of these genes, whether they turn on or they turn off. Well, science doesn't stop. And Dr. McCord and his team at Pathways Biosciences discovered that they can make a much more potent NRF2 activator than they had previously in this product called Protandem. And they also realized that product has some limitations. Well, even though it represented the cutting edge of research in 2006, now fast forward to 2017, it didn't. There simply had been a lot more discovery take place. And so we were lucky enough to license what is now the most potent NRF2 activator in the world, fully 10 times more potent than Protandem, which doesn't mean that Protandem is not a great product. It was, and it still remains a good product, but many of you have heard me use this example before. Back in 2008, 2007, when I first heard about Protandem, the phone I used was not this iPhone, okay? They didn't have iPhones in 2007. I was using a really cool Razer phone, flip phone, that had great ringtones. And you know, it could take pictures and it could text very clumsily. You all remember AAABBBCCC. And it could do some things like that, but it's very limited. And, but it represented pretty much the cutting edge of phone research, of mobile phone research at that time. And so we were all happy to have those phones. But now we would never trade our smartphones for those flip phones, even though they still make phone calls, they still have cameras and they still can text, although much, much more. But now they really are a traveling office. That's why I can be at Cabo and still do all my work and stay connected to my office and everything else I've got to do, largely by virtue of having a smartphone. And so that represents the type of product that we have now. We're gonna talk a little bit more about that. Now, the best evidence that I can offer, I can give you scientific studies, I can give you personal testimonials about the various products that we have. And we have more than just the product I mentioned that we call genomics, and that stands for genome expression. But I think that the actual best evidence of the type of company that we are in every single facet are those people, including yourselves, who choose to join and become part of the company. And that nowhere is that better represented than with our advisory board. We simply have an embarrassment of riches. Now, I've been the CEO of a number of companies, and some of them have been very large companies, some of them have been much smaller. And in each case, we aligned ourselves with scientists and with advisors. But in no case have I ever been part of a company that's been able to attract such a stellar number of individuals who are so accomplished in their areas of expertise and have joined our company. With, for example, Dr. Joe Maroon, I'm going to let you in on a little secret. We are going to be having our global virtual meeting coming up on July 24th, Saturday, July 24th, starting at 9 a.m. And that's going to be a 3-hour meeting. And there are going to be a lot of really great things going on. But one of those is that we're going to hear from Dr. Maroon, who is a world famous neurosurgeon. He's also the chief neurosurgeon and head doctor for the Pittsburgh Steelers. He's the medical director for the World Wrestling Entertainment Group, WWE, and still affiliated with the University of Pittsburgh Medical School. He is incredibly accomplished. And his assistant, physician assistant, Jeff Bost, who together they've done over 30,000 neurosurgeries, and they are very well versed in all types of science that relates to neurological disorders and the connection between the brain and the gut. And that pertains to our product that we call Link. And the reason we called it Link is because of that more increasingly well-known connection between the gut and the brain, the gut-brain axis. And so we've been able to attract people like him. We've been able to attract people like Vice Admiral Matt Winter, who at the time, now he's retired. He retired about 18 months ago from the Navy. But at the time that he joined our company, he was still a sitting, serving U.S. Admiral. And you can imagine that the Navy doesn't just let their admirals do anything they want to, especially someone like him, because at the time he had a very, very challenging position as the head of the Joint Strike Force, developing a new fighter for all the combined services and allies of the United States. Now, the good news about it is that he's also a scientist by training himself. And he had been previously the head of the Office of Naval Research. And so he knew a lot about products like ours. And we had to actually be vetted and thoroughly reviewed, not just from our products, but from our financials, the type of our business model, all had to be reviewed by the Navy's lawyers before they would even let him consider joining us. Fortunately, we passed that review, and Admiral Matt Winter is part of our advisory board. Dr. Brett Earle, who's a leading foundational medicine specialist, after 18 years in the emergency as an emergency room physician, he himself encountered a health issue that Western medicine simply just wasn't that effective in helping him resolve. So he decided to branch out and do some other things, not forgetting all of his training and all of his years of experience, but augmenting and supplementing that knowledge and that experience with things that Western medicine either is slow to embrace or just doesn't have the time or doesn't have the focus, because they're so busy treating things, they don't have time to really prevent things from happening. And that is where his focus is and where his clinical practice is now. Similarly, Sinead Irwin is also a registered foundational medicine specialist. And she was formerly an international investment banker. Again, very similar story to Dr. Earle, because she went through some health issues that she was having a very difficult time resolving through traditional methods. She went back and said, you know what, I guess I just have to take my health into my own hands and see what I can do. And that's actually great advice for all of us, which isn't to say that we can't rely upon experts and people who have learned and dedicated their lives to science. But at the end of the day, the responsibility for our health and for our family's health is really in our hands. And there is so much that we truly can control and take control of, which I guess can be a little intimidating, but it can also be very, very freeing as well. We have Dr. Hernandez, who is a longtime colleague of Dr. Joe McCord, whom I mentioned earlier, and is also in his own right, a foremost authority in oxidative stress. Dr. Rish Patel, a pain management specialist out of New York, and he's one that speaks very clearly and deeply about the effects of products like Optimend, which is our product, which is our tetrahydrocurcumin product, that has been shown to be much more easily absorbed and vastly superior in terms of its ability to deal with pain and inflammation than other products that are out there on the market. Richard Jones, who is a very well-known media expert and executive, and who's also been very instrumental in having our products and our company featured on ABC and on various networks and is also actually letting us use his studio, their studio in Salt Lake City, to originate our virtual conference coming up in July. And I mentioned Jeff Bose earlier. Now to our products. They're the real stars of the show. I mentioned genomics, which stands for genome expression. That NRF2 activation that I mentioned before actually activates. And I was actually on the phone with Dr. McCord just this last week. And we were talking about this product and the science behind it. And we were talking about it because I asked him a specific question. Some of you that may have been familiar with Protandim in the past might remember this question. For the most part, all of our products can be used by virtually anyone, even if they're taking prescription drugs, because by virtue of the way that they are metabolized, they don't hit the same receptors, they're metabolized in different ways, and so there's no inherent conflict or contraindication with our products and drug products. There was one case, however, that worried me a little bit. I have a good friend of mine whose daughter suffers from cystic fibrosis, which, as you might remember, is a defect, a genetic defect, actually, which doesn't allow those patients, those sufferers, to effectively clear mucus that develops with all of us in our lungs, because it doesn't have a certain enzyme that will clear it. And so this mucus builds up and blocks the airways, so they can't breathe, and they gradually lose lung function and essentially suffocate. And she had, when her breathing capacity, lung capacity was reduced to 18%. And now think about that. Think about getting only being able to breathe 18% of what you're able to do normally. She was finally able to get a lung transplant, and that increased her lung capacity up to 70%. And that was about 7 years ago. And in talking to my friend a few weeks ago, he mentioned that while it's still great, it had regressed a little bit to 50%. And so I sent him our products. And said, listen, she's suffering from oxidative stress. She's got other issues. Cystic fibrosis patients almost in all cases have real gut issues. And there's a connection between that and their microbiome. And so there's pain and inflammation associated with that. But I was a little concerned about genomics because I knew that she was probably on immunosuppressants, which are drugs designed to downregulate the immune system so that it doesn't view these lungs, in this case a transplant, as a foreign object and turn on the full effect of the immune system and reject it. And so so the concern I had was, well, if our products are upregulating and spurring on the immune system, is that going to be an issue? And so in talking to Dr. McCord, I said, you know, Joe, he and I have known each other a long time, so we call each other by our first names. And I said, now, the way I've always viewed the way that genomics works is not so much just upregulating immune system genes and downregulating inflammatory cytokines or genes associated with inflammation, as much as modulating them and turning them on when they're supposed to be on and turning them off when they're supposed to be off. I said, is that the correct way of looking at it? And he actually paid me a great compliment. I said, yeah, David, modulation is a great word used to describe it. He said, and I have no concerns with this young woman taking genomics because I think it's going to be fine. In fact, there's a lot of research that would show that it would be good for her to take. And so what we're really doing then is with all of our products, whether it be genomics in regards to its ability to modulate literally thousands of what are called survival genes, whether it be butyric acid, which is the main ingredient in Link, and is a natural short chain fatty acid that friendly bacteria in our colon make. But as we get older, we simply don't make enough of it for our body to fully utilize. And what it does is it helps heal the stomach cells. It's the food of choice for endothelial cells. It helps downregulate genes associated with inflammation. And really importantly, especially as I get older, it's also involved in neurogenesis or the creation of new brain cells. So it's an awesome, awesome foundational ingredient foundational molecule as Dr. Earl would describe it. Or Optimend, which takes tetrahydrocurcumin, which is what our body converts turmeric and curcumin into. And we start with the final product. And then we put that tetrahydrocurcumin into a molecule of cyclodextrin, just like we do a butyric acid with link. And we put each molecule into a molecule of cyclodextrin so that the body can safely and much more effectively absorb it and take it to where it can be metabolized and spread throughout the body. It's a key difference. That's what we call the Siloc delivery system is a patent pending process that no one else is going to be able to ever use, which guarantees the increased efficacy of our product versus anybody else who might be a pretender to some of the claims that we are making. But in any event, in each and every case, we're not doing to the body what the body's not already designed to do by itself. It's designed to heal. It's designed to thrive. It's designed to allow you to do things well into your upper ages and to remain being active and robust. It's just the things that we do to it by virtue of our diet, by virtue of our sedentary lifestyles, and sometimes just through sheer ignorance. And that's what we're sharing with the world, is that our tools and vehicles to snap ourselves out of these bad habits that maybe we've lapsed into. Now, of course, you know, our largest organ on our body is our skin, and our skin takes the brunt of everything. Okay, it not only reflects ultimately on the outside what we're doing to the inside, but it's also the gatekeeper in terms of keeping toxins and everything else that is subject to the elements. So that's where the Amora line comes in and rejuvenates and helps the body replenish collagen levels, vitamin C levels, and increase moisturization to diminish the effects of aging, the ravages of aging in terms of fine line wrinkles, and not just fine line wrinkles, maybe heavy wrinkles, age spots, discoloration that occurs. It's all designed to help us look and feel better. We talked a little bit about Genomics, Optimend, Link, and Amora. Now for our latest entry, and what some might consider to be the newest shining star in our product lineup, and that's Aero, because one thing that plays a great role in inflammation and in oxidative stress, and overall just not feeling very good and wanting to get out, is if we packed on what, I don't know, I've heard it variously described as the COVID 40, the COVID 20, the COVID 15, whatever it is, but by virtue of not being able to get out like we'd like to, sometimes, you know, we packed a little bit more weight on. And you know, it's not always our fault, really. We sometimes want to say, well, it's just because of lack of discipline or lack of, you know, willpower or whatever. No, that's not it. I mean, yeah, we probably all could get a little bit better. We could probably all be a little bit more dedicated, but we are kind of playing against a stacked deck, if you will. And that is because as we eat processed foods, as we eat fast foods, so many things that are part of our diet in a very active, you know, rapid paced world, they're actually designed to create addictive behavior, for us to be addicted to the sugar and salt and fat that's in these products. And it rewires our brain, literally. And so we need some great epigenetic tools to fight back. And we put them in Aero so that we can balance our blood sugar levels so that we're not going to get those cravings for those carbs and the fast food that are otherwise being engineered into us. We're actually with our inulin, agave inulin and the African mango, we're actually recruiting bad fat cells to turn into good fat cells, white fat cells into brown fat cells. Look it up. I'm not just making this stuff up. And we're also increasing the number of mitochondria, the number of power plants in each cell, so that each cell can burn more calories faster and longer by virtue of including guarana in it, as well as, you know, a whole host of energizers in the form of B vitamin, green coffee bean extract, with a nice slate of vitamins and minerals as well. So there you have it. And I'm going to stop talking for a minute. Whenever I get going, you can tell two things, I hope. One, that I'm not quite recovered as a lawyer, that once I get talking, I really get talking. And number two, I do feel passionate, very passionately about what we're doing here at Actives, what we have to offer and the way that we can change lives. So I'm going to stop talking for a minute, and I'm going to ask if anyone has any questions.